While I was filming this video of me cleaning up my yard and organizing stuff and throwing out junk I don't need, I realized it's been 3 years since I uploaded my first random bits. It actually occurred to me because I was thinking about moving an engine that I was like, wow, it's been there since random bits 1 3 years ago. Holy crap. Not sure if it's today that's the 3-year anniversary, but definitely by the time this gets uploaded, it'll be already 3 years. I probably won't bother uploading it on the exact day, though. But yeah, she's like, that's weird. It's amazing. It's like, 3 years? Really? Wow. Doesn't seem that long ago. And then I think about all the stuff that's changed. Like, for instance, solar panel system, electric lawn tractor, working at Apple, going to California for a year and a half, doing all that shit. And then it's like, okay, actually, that seems like longer than 3 years because that was a long time ago. And I had far less expertise in batteries and stuff like that. I don't think I'd even really messed with... Had I messed with lithium batteries yet? I think I was just starting to mess with lithium batteries. But yeah, just like, wow, it's amazing. I bet those 3 years of random bits, if I go back and watch them, that'll be a pretty good, like... Probably captured a lot of my life and how my life changed, you know what I mean? So yeah, it's amazing. So many bugs out here. Think of, the bugs think I'm at some kind of buffet or whatever when I'm sitting down, but oh well. I find random bits fun to record. I find it fun to hear responses about it. I don't find it fun to edit, and I hate watching it. It's fucking annoying to watch it. But I think that me making random bits was a very good addition to my channel. Because without random bits, without my personality, I don't really do much that's really interesting. You know what I mean? Because maybe every so often I'll make a lawn tractor or something like that that can push dirt. But overall, that's just like, it's very hit and miss with like the kind of things that I tinker around with. Most of my stuff is just me goofing off. And if you don't really have like much of a personality, like a character on your channel to goof off, then it's like, you're just goofing off then. It's kind of boring. So I think having random bits and informing people of the things that are going on in my life and everything, I think that helps make things a little more entertaining to some people. Although I don't understand it. Well, I don't understand it for my videos. It's funny. I watch other people's videos. Like, for instance, Ozzy50. Anything he makes, I'll watch it all the way through. Because he's like, oh, awesome. What's going on in your life? I'll definitely keep this video series up. Well, anyway, let's get back to cleaning the yard. Here's the video. So, guys, my first step to really start working outside. At least in a long time. Because before, it's just been vacations. But now I'm actually living here again. And I have time to do stuff. So, let's start making a nice place to do stuff. I think first goal is to mow the yard. And so, a necessary goal is to clean it up. You need to get rid of some stuff. I still want to clean up redo the burn pit. Because dig out all the ash and all that kind of stuff. Oh, what are you whining about? All that stuff was supposed to go to the recycling center. Actually, that stuff too. It's pretty... Oh! We have a good amount of space back here. We shall start ripping up those skids, those pallets, so we can burn those. I'm not sure where the other ladders came from. That's interesting. Oh, they're by the house up there. I can use those as a structural piece if I ever need. And yeah, so I think we should redesign this area. Make sure there's no water for mosquitoes. Right, and over there is some more junk, so let's go around here. An immediate goal for me, and actually for my mom also, is to fix whatever is going on with that shed. Most likely take it all apart and redesign it so I can have a nice little workshop. And then in the future, maybe a few years from now, I want to just remove these white tarp sheds. Those two white tarp sheds have been, well, we got them in like 2005, so they last 11 years now. I think it was 2005. They are freaking old. I'm going to go through there, get rid of more stuff. I'm going to go back here, get rid of, ooh, spiders. Yeah. Going to get rid of more stuff back here and clean out this area so we can have a nice area. Now the thing is, underneath here is an entire foundation. Because there used to be a big, like, almost, like, oh, not a two-car garage. A single car garage with extra space, I think. So I would like to just rebuild that garage. That way, if I ever, or actually whenever I move out, because I would hope eventually my projects could afford their own place, so I can move on, like, YouTube work stuff to an actual, like, location, like, in the woods or something like that. And then, so then my mom can have whatever is the building that's left over to park a car in. That's going to be pretty nice. Alright, so I guess if we want to mow the yard, we have to make sure the mower works. Looking good. So that's been charging for a while, at least it should have been. Nice. So it still works. That's good. I love it when things just, they last. Because that, even that little, oh, right, we've been having poison ivy issues in here. I will be more attentive about where I step. I don't see any there right now, so I think it's all gone for now. Yes. Although somebody else probably doesn't want me to cut down the jungle. My cat likes running through tall weeds and stuff like that. But it's my house. I have cats. Actually, it's my mom's house. But my power supersedes the power of symbol. Yeah, because see, there used to be a garage there. And that's why there's all this gravel here, because it seems to be a driveway going all the way up there. Oh, right. Got to clean out this stuff, too. I love insulators. They're so cool. Finding a use for all this stuff, too, so that'll be nice. I can just make a pile of junk, and then later today, me and my mom can maybe spend some time to run it to the recycling center so we can just get rid of this shit.
Oh, wait a minute. I just realized. This is Illinois. This isn't California where you have to recycle everything. I can just throw it in the trash. Plus, to be honest, I think in the future we're going to be harvesting valuable materials from landfills, so it's not gone forever, you know, because there is a lot of valuable materials in landfills. Just a matter of finding a machine capable, or building a contraption capable of digging it up and extracting the different materials without wasting too much power.
A little bit overfull, actually, so that's fine. That thing is so smoky. Maybe I should finally do an engine teardown. Yeah, I mean, it's even still releasing smoke. I wonder if there's like a, could it be a broken thing, or? It's not too hot, though. So I figure if I just do it in short bursts, it should be okay for just a little while until I can take it apart. What the fuck? Oh, Aaron, I forgot. This is probably my mom's. Yeah. My mom likes to find beautiful feathers or skulls or bones and stuff on the side of the road and like preserve them or whatever and just have them around. Looks like she found a turkey or something like that died and she's letting the flesh rot off the feathers. Which is cool. It's a cool thing because then we'll have some neat feathers.
A while back, my mom actually found a fox, a roadkill fox on the side of the road. And so she cut the tail off and got one of our friends to taxidermy the tail, so now I have a fox tail. It's kind of cool. It's really fluffy and it's neat.
shame you got hit, but hey, better than it rotting.
Where's my hook?
Oh. It's actually where I usually keep it.
Amazing.
A nice hook is also good for probing, too. So I think I can mow here without hitting anything noticeable. I think I might be in need of some new front tires. That's the inner tube through that. It's amazing. I mean, it's just a lawnmower. It doesn't go very fast, but still, it's like, ugh. That's really gone down. Granted, I did run this on flat. I'm just gonna mow this real quick, this full section, and then I can get back to all the other stuff. Seem to be smoking that much, so that's cool, but that front wheel is really messing me up. Can't turn. Yeah, it's totally gone. Gasoline power blowtorch is a wonderful fire starter, but even better coupled with a blower. Yeah, it's pretty warm. That's a pretty warm fire. It's the next day, and it's trash day, so we have a full trash can to put stuff in. Now before we move on to that stuff over there, that wood, I think we should mow this area right here. Just this little section right here, and make sure there's no bricks in the way to kill my mower. This stuff's still good. I'm definitely not going to trash that, but just don't need it over here right now. Now, this is the scary part of mowing, the aftermath, because it's like, oh, that could have gone bad. Oh, that could have gone bad. That's about it. But yeah, it's like, oh, wow. Oh, wow, they're really mad now. It's a cute little engine. I really like it. Got it for like $50. And it's very mobile if you move it the way I did. Nice. You know, maybe this shed I built isn't so much of a failure. Maybe I shouldn't hate it as much, because, I mean, it holds my ladder fine. My great-grandfather's ladder. It's been outside for years, though, and we need to take better care of it. We just never had any place to put it because it's so long. Well, now we do. Whoa. Oh, look at that. This is actually part of a tree that we cut down like 15 years ago. They're really big logs to burn. So we just haven't really messed with them yet. Just had a nice chat with my neighbor, neighbor to the north, that's what I call him. He's a really, really nice guy, and he lent me his cutters. So I'm feeling a bit daring, and it's like a 98% humidity out here, so I really don't feel like working any harder. What if I just try to plow over that with my lawnmower? I mean, what's the worst that could happen? That's what I was stuck on. More metal. Once again, that could have gone bad. And that is why I tried the first run without the blade running. You never know what you're gonna run over.
Is that concrete?
Yeah, it looks like concrete. And judging by how it's like raised up, I'm thinking the frost that pushed it up there must not be too deep.
I don't know what was there. I never even noticed that until just now.
Yeah. I'm probably going to crack it open. See what's underneath there. And see if there is anything else going in. I mean, I should have another part of the yard here. I think that turned out pretty well. Well, I'm glad that my neighbor lent me those tools because I couldn't find mine. Unfortunately, my lawnmower is still giving me issues. It's So now I have two bad tires. The pulley keeps popping off. Or actually, more accurately, it keeps turning upside down and then popping off. And hasn't been smoking as much. So that's good. But still. I'm happy that I got this done. And my neighbor actually said that he would spray some ivy killer on there, so we wouldn't have to worry about those vines killing the tree anymore. Oh, may I get through? I'll have to step over here. Lazy bum. So it's the next day, and I think I can... I think I should continue where I left off. Because I was kind of just fed up with clearing the brush and all the lawnmower issues, because this thing is being a little finicky. I'm not going to deal with clearing up any more brush today, but I'm going to see about clearing off that concrete slab as much as I can, stacking the bricks under there, then using the cart to put the engine and stuff into the shed, the new one. And then it occurred to me, I can actually start dumping all the ash from our fireplace over here. Because one of the issues I had was, well, aside from all the random junk in here, primarily I just kept getting my lawnmower stuck on the really big roots here. So, if I fill in the dirt around it with, like, ash or something, that should be fine. I'm pretty happy about how far that thing held up so far, though, because it's really had no maintenance for several years. Well, almost no maintenance. And there we go. Should keep the battery nice and fresh. Keep this concrete slab around for a little while. It's actually kind of useful now. I didn't really think about putting all my railroad rails on there. Well, at least my small ones. These are just from mines. Come to think of it, I'm not sure what happened to my big section of rail, because I had a much bigger one from an actual, like, outdoor railroad, you know? That fits nicely there. I might move it back further later on, but who knows. Man, it's gotten a bit extra humid all of a sudden. I think it's going to rain tonight. It's probably a good idea to put all this stuff up anyway. Oh yeah, storm is definitely coming in. Well, I had a really enjoyable past, 3 days? Yeah, this has been... Yeah, 3 days, wow. But it's been 3 years since I started this series, so that's also been fun too. Still can't believe that's been 3 years. I feel like I've done pretty good progress. I'm going to take a break from this for a little bit. Oh, one more brick. Going to get some parts for the lawnmower. Going to work on that. Maybe do a video about my electric bicycle. Take that stuff to the recycling center because it's shit. Maybe find a place because I have to think, like, where do I want this? I might just put it up near the house, but I don't know. I want to get this all cleared off. And we'll get rid of that thing. That thing's a piece of shit. So yeah, I'm actually pretty happy. This was really enjoyable, especially to finally get that stuff taken down. I feel like a new drive to do all this stuff. It's so awesome. I hope that doesn't go away. I hope I keep that drive for a while. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and thank you very much for watching. See ya!